What's wrong with all these ballasts? I replaced over 50 of them this month.
I don't know. I called the manufacturer. They just keep failing. They say it's an overvoltage, but we have surge protection, so I don't know what's going on.
When failures occur from over or under voltages, people often think that these are transient or short-term events, but in fact, they are often long-term issues related to voltage regulation on the utility system. Utilities are required to maintain minimum and maximum voltage levels, usually plus or minus 5% of nominal at their customer service. Utilities use integrated volt-var compensation, or IVVC, to optimize the voltage quality and maintain a flat voltage profile. The benefit for the customer or end user is a much more stable voltage for their loads. The benefits for the utility include optimized power factor, reduced line losses, and demand control with a program called Conservation Voltage Reduction, or CVR, where required.
Are they from the North Tower?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, they were. And now you say that, I was reading over 520 volts with my voltmeter up there. Would that have something to do with it?
That makes sense. They had a regulator fail, which caused a voltage issue from the utility source.
In this video, we will discuss the methods and benefits of integrated volt-var compensation using voltage regulators and power factor correction that work together to optimize voltage quality on utility power systems.
Utilities and end users can maintain voltage levels with transformers, and they can fine-tune the voltage with transformer taps. The taps on utility transformers are called de-energized tap changers, as they must be adjusted manually and with the power removed from the transformer. However, because of the dynamic nature of utility systems, where load changes affect voltage levels on that feeder, parallel feeders, and other parts of the interconnected utility system, utilities use automatic or self-regulating voltage management equipment, including automatic tap changers and voltage regulators. Without control, voltage levels are usually low during the day under heavy load conditions and high overnight during light loads. So what is a voltage regulator and how does it work? This voltage regulator is a 32-step plus minus 10% auto transformer. It will sense and respond to high or low voltage to buck or boost the voltage to maintain a desired level. As you can see here, these are single phase regulators and operate to maintain the voltage level on each of the three phases independently to balance the voltage. Notice that these voltage regulators are only a fraction of the kVA size of the load they feed. Once a voltage is out of band or out of the desired limits, the regulator will initiate a tap change after a programmed time delay. Then, the taps will continue to change automatically about every 2 seconds until the desired level is achieved. These regulators can be installed in the utility substation or on a feeder. For long feeders, where the regulator is installed in the substation, utilities may program the regulator as line drop compensators or LDCs. LDCs estimate the voltage drop based on the current flowing through the feeder and will calculate the expected voltage drop based on the resistance and reactance of the line. Then, they will boost the voltage level above the desired level at the substation so that the voltage level at the load connection point is within the desired range. All of these voltage regulators and LDCs operate in automatic mode, but they can be controlled manually or through utility automation systems.
Power factor correction in the form of capacitor banks, like this one, also helps the utilities to support their voltage throughout the system. In general, loads on the system pull the voltage down, and capacitors push the voltage up. Strategically placing capacitor banks in substations and capacitor racks on utility poles provide this needed support. Voltage sensing combined with power factor measurements allows these capacitors to be turned on and off to raise or lower the voltage as necessary to track the load. Working with voltage regulators, automatically switched capacitors help to stabilize the voltage and offer additional benefits to both the utilities and end users. For the utilities, the losses are reduced by optimizing the power factor with an IVVC system, since IVVC reduces the current to the load and that reduces I squared R losses. Loss reduction is typically 1 to 4%. For end users, in conjunction with the voltage stabilization the capacitors offer, when the capacitors are on their side of the meter, customers can often avoid power factor penalties that may range from 5 to 25% of their bill. Other forms of power factor correction include static var compensators and stat comms for very large dynamic loads like an arc furnace in a steel mill.
Like water flowing over a waterfall, power likes to flow from a higher voltage to a lower voltage. So, if multiple sources of power are used on an interconnected utility system, voltage control helps to push the power to where it is needed. Systems that have photovoltaic sources of power, like this large solar farm, often interact with the utility IBVC system, and care must be taken to account for the difference in voltage produced by this new source. In addition, when a cloud covers the sun temporarily, utilities often face voltage stabilization issues resulting from a dramatic drop in the output voltage when the PV system temporarily reduces its production. Utility IBVC systems are able to respond to changes like cloud cover, but often not fast enough for the issue to go unnoticed by end users. Strategies are in place to optimize these systems and even predict impending changes to maintain voltage quality through such a dramatic change. For example, with large systems, energy storage is often used to buffer the change until the regulators and capacitors can catch up with the adjusted load and voltage levels.
All of the control equipment required to regulate the voltage to within acceptable levels can be manually adjusted, but most are automatically adjusted as part of an overall utility strategy through a SCADA system. An integrated IVVC system is part of a utility feeder automation system, like this Eaton feeder automation software. These systems are continually adjusted as new loads are added and old loads are retired, as well as when new sources are added or removed from the system. With voltage regulators and power factor correction equipment working together, customers experience the voltage quality that their loads require, and utilities optimize their system. With IVVC, utilities can also reduce the loading on their system during peak demands through a program called Conservation Voltage Reduction, or CVR. With CVR, the utilities maintain a lower targeted voltage in an effort to reduce the overall demand on the system. A 5 to 10% lower operating voltage may yield a 3 to 6% lower power demand on the system. During peak demand periods, CVR can help utilities prevent brownouts or even rolling blackouts.
As we add more and more loads that are sensitive to over and under voltage conditions, utilities are tasked with maintaining stable voltage for their customers. Voltage quality is maintained via integrated volt-var compensation using software to control voltage regulators and power factor correction equipment to optimize the cost and quality.
Here at the PSEC, you can see firsthand how all these pieces of equipment are integrated to provide the quality we all expect from our utility source. To learn more about volt-var compensation, contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.